Hi, I'm Ethan Connor, Technical Engagement Engineer at Grape City Developer Solutions. In this video, we're going to show you how to drill through from one report to another. In other words, how to display a child report when a user clicks on some text or an object in the main report. We will continue to use the report we created in the Getting Started video. As a reminder, this is an inventory report using a table that is grouped on product categories. It shows each product's name, color, price, and size. Also, I have a second report showing a list of recent orders including the customer's name, the quantity they ordered, the price per quantity, any discount we're giving them, and a total for that line item. We want to drill through the first report, the inventory report, to see the recent orders report for a particular product category. If we click on the image of a product category in the inventory report, the recent orders report for that product category should display. We need to pass at least one parameter from the inventory report to the recent orders to place a filter on the product category we select. Title the recent orders report to include the name of the product that we just clicked on. We will start by adding the recent orders report to the Visual Studio project. With the recent orders report now open in Visual Studio, add two parameters. In the ActiveReports 12 Report Explorer, right-click on the Parameters node and add a parameter. Name this parameter Product ID and click the Hidden checkbox. The Hidden checkbox hides this parameter from the user so that they don't know about this parameter and won't interact with it. In the same Parameters dialog box, click the green plus icon to add a second parameter to the report. Name this parameter the product name. Again, make this a hidden parameter. Click OK to close this dialog box. In the design view, include the value of the product name parameter in the text box used for the title of the report. Change the plain text value to an expression that will include both text and parameter value. In order to filter the data by the product category, we need to edit the query in this report. To do so, right-click on the orders dataset and select Edit. In the Parameters tab, create a parameter, name it Query Parameter, and pass the value from the Product ID Report parameter. On the Query tab, modify the query to filter the data based on the parameter. Click OK to close the dataset dialog box. Back on the inventory report, set an action event on the image. To do this, select the image embedded in the first cell of the table and bring up the property dialog box. Under the Navigation tab, I will select Jump to Report and then select the Recent Orders report from the dropdown. We will need to add two parameters to pass to the recent orders report. Make sure that the names here match the parameter names assigned in the recent orders report and click OK to close. When we view the inventory report, we can drill through to the recent orders report and show a list of customers who have ordered the products I click on. Let's take a look. Viewing the inventory report, we can drill through to the recent orders report and show a list of customers who have ordered the products clicked on. All of these enhancements and more are available at grapecity.com, and be sure to tune into our blogs in the coming weeks as we'll be offering more detail on new product features. You can also get the newest version of ActiveReports by downloading it from the site today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.